tosses tails, the brutal feudal system, holy crusades, bubonic plague. Can't say that we really missed 'em. So dark and barbaric, so dull and mundane, that was so Middle Ages, that was so Charlemagne. Welcome to the Renaissance, poets, painters, and bone buffoons, and merry minstrels who stroll the streets of London, a strum in their lutes,
in poppy pants and pointy leather boots.
Welcome to the
and a stage, incredible.
it's so frustrating. Cause if your name is Shakespeare, you're hotter than hot. But if you're any other writer, then you're not.
Oh, noble kinsman, the royal blood and love do bind. Seek now thy own succor and flee thy native land. To die today will not be done till dawn. Da-dee-da-dum, da dee. Who talks like this? Nigel, can't we just write like we speak?
Yeah, I haven't understood a single word in our last three plays.
Did I miss my cue? Robin, what are you wearing? This isn't dress rehearsal.
Oh, I thought I might help me get into character if I would wear dresses and hang out in taverns and flirt with men. You know, for research.
Nick, I have a question about motivation.
Yes.
Why haven't you given up yet?
Here, this one is working. I can feel it. It's just missing something right here. Nigel, it'll help.
You know what? I did some writing in my notebook last night, and I thought it might be good if King Richard was contemplating his own mortality. You know, now that I'm sitting out loud, it's not stupid.
But the scene, Nigel.
Oh, that's really bad, isn't it? I don't know why you even bother letting me write with you.
Nigel, it's good. Yeah. It's really good.
Well, I put a lot of layers in it.
How about instead of tombstones, he says epitaph?
Oh, that's better.
Okay, everyone take your places. Let's get this a try, huh? Let us talk of graves, of words, of epitaph. Then dust our paper and with rainy eyes write sorrow on the bosom of the earth. Yes! That is good! I'm starting to think this is going to be the Bottom Brothers' first hit!
Pity we have to shut it down!
Oh, Lord Clapham, what do you mean, shut it down?
Guess whose next production is going to be the tragedy of Richard II.
What, Shakespeare? Why is he doing Richard II? He just did Richard III, who goes backwards.
He makes a convention, that's what makes it so great.
Oh, yeah? Have you seen Romeo and Juliet? What's so great about two lovers who kill themselves in the end?
Who's spoke it? I'm seeing it this evening.
It is life-changing. Oh,
is it? Is it love you stab myself, drink poison, the end?
No, stop it! You're ruining everything! I paid for an original play, and it will lose my patronage, do ya? No more money, unless I hear a new idea on the morrow.
I think that means tomorrow.
If he quits, we're all out of shop.
Or Clapham, please.
Write something original, like the bar.
The Bard. Why is he the Bard? He's a Bard. Like, I'm a Bard. You're a Bard. He's just one of the Bards.
He's the Bard because he does it all. Tragedies, histories, comedies.
Comedy. Name one thing of his that's funny. Give me a line, anything.
Okay, on my word, we'll not carry coals, for then we should be colliers.
That's not funny! Oh, God, I hate Shakespeare. That's right, I said it. I hate Shakespeare. I just don't get it. How a mediocre actor from a measly little town is suddenly the brightest jewel in England's royal crown. Oh, God, I hate Shakespeare. His plays are wordy, but oh no, the great Shakespeare. That old turd, he has no sense about the audience. He makes them feel so dumb. That bastard doesn't care that my poor ass is getting numb.
How can you say that? How can you say that?
It's easy, I can say it, but it's absolutely true.
Don't be a penis, a man is a genius.
And the penis is controlling all of you.
Why, she's brilliant. What majesty flows from his pen. This poetry soars like a sweet violin. God's own inspiration, like lightning that strike him. And he captures my soul.
Oh, jeez, you sound just like him.
Really? Thanks.
You should hate Shakespeare.
Well, I don't. I try to emulate Shakespeare.
Well, there's your problem. You're so blinded by the Lord, who's such a pompous man.
Why is it a problem to admit that I'm a fan?
Because he's a hack with a knack for stealing anything he can.
How can you say that? How can you say that the man really knows how to write a kitchen play? You wish you could bend one. You wish we were in one.
I just wish that he would go away.
Everybody I know says that he is the greatest writer.
about Shakespeare and how they prattle on about his great accomplishments. Well, la-di-da-di-da. And once they start their gumption, there's no stopping them. And this is about Shakespeare. And he looks in his dumb dumb. Writing is divine. A rose by any other name is such a clever line. They're all so stop, and they're all getting all and I'm really getting sick of it. And
hey, right now, I think by now we sort of know you hate Shakespeare.
Shakespeare, the way he thinks you believe when all he does is gloat. The way he wears that silly frilly collar around his throat. The poster child for why no one should ever procreate. I made a shorter list than I will give it to you. Every little thing about Shakespeare is what I hate.
Stop it!
Now, I know
put any money in there, and that's why I was thinking I could get a job.
What? No! If you get a job, it'll just make me feel like a failure. None of the other writers' wives have jobs.
Well, they should. This is the 90s. We have a woman on the throne. And by the year 1600, women will be completely equal to men. I just thought of the perfect job for me. I could be in your play.
What? You can't act? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Got this.
But you know it's forbidden to put women on stage.
Yeah, and anyway, our play's been canceled.
What?
Not canceled! Nine. That's such a negative way to put it. I mean, yes, we are no longer doing Richard II, but only because we have come up with a better idea.
What is that?
Can't say, we don't want to jinx it.
So there is no idea.
Well, we have had the idea that we need an idea.
Let me help you. I could go out there and earn some money and take the pressure off of you guys.
Hey, listen.
Nope, you listen. Because I just want to make things better. And I need to know that you understand. If you ever got in trouble, I would be there on the double just to bail you out. If there's anything you lack, you know I've always got your back. That's what it's all about.
God, I hate Shakespeare. But when I sit sit and really contemplate Shakespeare. I guess I hate the fact that he is everything I ever dreamed that I could be. I mostly hate the way he makes me feel about me. 'Cause the truth is, it wouldn't be that bad to be Shakespeare. In fact, I'd give my left nad to be Shakespeare. If I could only have one tiny little smidgen of his notoriety, it would relieve me of the pressures of responsibility. I've gotta make it happen, gotta find my pot of gold. If there was just some way to know just what the future holds. What the future holds! But I need more than luck. Hey, I'm looking for a soothsayer.
Your bird than knowledge shows to be the best.
Out of business due to unforeseen circumstances. So obviously not the very best.
Yeah, here I mean, but you just seeing. Seeing is what you need. Help is what you need. I can see you. If neither is what you need, well, I foresee you leaving very shortly. So, am I hired? Actually, I know I will be. I'm just being polite.
Well, who are you?
I am Nostradamus.
The Nostradamus?
No. I'm his nephew, Thomas.
Thomas Nostradamus?
I promise. I share the same gifts as my esteemed uncle, and for half a crown, I'll share those gifts with you. And I predict for you a new life with no teeth. That was a freebie.
I'll keep looking if you don't mind.
Yes, you just said. But beware the sign of the black dog.
Right. Thank you. Good luck in the asylum. Half a crown, you said.
Excellent. Now, what is it you wish the future to tell?
Well, I'm a writer, and I want you to look into the future and tell me what the next big thing in the theater will be, what audiences will be lining up to see.
All right, stand back in space. In the future, the theaters are very nice. Cushy red seats. And a roof.
Wait, what?
Unbelievable.
What is it?
That much for a glass of wine?
How about what's on the stage?
Oh, yes, right. Get it back in. Yeah. Oh. 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 What spectacle? I have seen the future!
What is it?
The biggest, most fantastic thing in the theater will be... musicals!
What?
Musicals!
What the hell are musicals?
It appears to be a play where the dialogue stops and the plot is made for songs!
Oh, wait. So, an actor is saying his lines, and then, out of nowhere, he just starts singing?
Yes!
Well, that is the stupidest thing that I've ever. You're doing a play, got something to say, so you sing it. It's absurd. Who on earth is going to sit there while an actor breaks into song? What possible thought could the audience think other than this is horribly wrong?
Remarkably, they won't think that.
Seriously, why not?
Because it's, oh, musical. A musical. Nothing such a big thing as a musical. Oh, it's song and dance and sweet romance. And how to get things happen, I haven't been spent. Bright lights, stage lights, and a dazzling chorus. You're to be For a very long time. Suddenly changed to a different note.
You know it.
And it's supposed to create a dramatic effect. But mostly you just sit there asking yourself, why aren't they talking?
Sounds miserable.
I believe it's pronounced miserable.
People actually like this?
No, they love it! It's such a delight! amazing that a music hall with song and dance and sweet romance. And in the music hall we might have a chance.
Who's us? Make a pause and everyone cheers for us.
Forget about her, that will never work. Now listen, you know with an open mind because it's a bit radical.
Okay, what is it?
A musical! It's a play with songs, but the songs advance the plot and develop character as they seamlessly segue from dialogue into singing.
That is the most amazing idea! Yeah. That's brilliant, actually. I mean, how bad is to express the inner longings of the human soul? They're musical! Oh, you're always writing songs on your lips!
I already dusted it off and started banging out a few tunes. And all those poems of yours, there's your lyrics.
Oh, this is perfect, Curtis!
That is not important, but this is...
Yeah, a musical!
Now, we just have to figure out what it's about.
Oh, I still think we should write our life
story. Please, don't say two brothers from Cornwall.
Why not? I think we should write something that's emotionally true. Is it not?
We gotta think bigger. Was the Bible written from the heart?
Well, I would hope so.
Okay, it probably was. But Matthew, Mark, Luke...
No,
those writers, they were writing about an event, something big, epic, world-changing. Yes, I got it.
What?
Why didn't I think of this before?
What?
The most significant historical event in the last 1,000 years.
What's that coming up the Silk Road, out of China?
Let's walk it off, okay?
Oh, Audrey and Joe, Audrey!
Sorry, sir, begging your pardon. I know it's you.
But I fooled you for a second, didn't I? Tell me that.
What the hell are you doing dressed like that?
Remember that job I mentioned? Turns out all the good ones are for men.
B, this just makes me feel...
Is that a bucket of shit?
Bear shit, to be precise. I've been promoted this morning. I didn't have a bucket. And look, I already made a penny. I'm gonna put it in the money box.
No, I mean, I'll do it.
Yo! Bear shit, boy!
Hear that? I have a job title. One day, it'll be Bear Shit Woman!
What are we gonna do? Keep writing, I'll be back.
What? A woman?
Nigel? Nigel, I need you! I need you now! More than ever! I've got to go find us a new backer, which means that you need to come up with a new idea. I can count on you for that, right?
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Come on, Nigel. You can do this. Come on, you can do this. No, I can't do this. I can't think of anything. I'm totally stuck. I have no ideas. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Excuse me. Good day, mistress.
Good day, who knows? We're late with love. Till dusk of death did herald the eternal night.
I wrote that.
Yes, I know! I accidentally took this after our first encounter. Your sonnet, it's perfection.
Really?
You thought it was good?
It touched me in places I did not know it touched. Forgive me. Poetry is forbidden in my house, especially poems of earth and love. Oh, is there no pity in the clouds and seas into the bottom of my grief?
Oh, Romeo and Juliet, act his in by.
You've seen it?
6 times. And you?
8. Oh, my mother knew he would disown me.
Oh, my brother, too.
I adore Shakespeare.
Me, too. I am a comedy of errors. First edition.
And that's not number 1.
Like a lot of literature.
Like a lot of literature.
Like a lot of literature.
isn't true, but I was just a kid back then. It's not like he knows who I am or anything.
Master Nigel Bottom! An invitation from Master Shakespeare to be his personal guest at a recitation in the park.
Shakespeare in the park? Did you hear my plus one?
He was there. We watched them.
Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Stratford upon Avon, the king of cunts, the sultan of sons, the man who I am, and I am a pentameter. Put your hands together for the one, the only, William Shakespeare!
A little song that's been very good to me. Let's see if you know it.
Shall I compare me?
Now, yeah, all I say.
Yeah, now I'm a melody for Tiffany's. And the rock wind shakes the down on the mother may again. The seventh leaf.
I hope you sort of dance.
I adore the admiration of all this way of calling. It's quite a new sensation.
What shall we call it?
Do you want more?
No!
Well, when do you want it? Tomorrow?
No!
Later?
No!
Let me hear you say now!
No!
Very nice. Let me hear you say now! It's
now, baby!
The scams! Let me hear you say now! It's
now!
Now be good! Now do it with me.
Now is the winter of our Christmas head.
Now is the winter of our Christmas head.
Here's one for all you lovers.
But soft light through yonder window breaks. It is the east, and Juliet is the sun, a wrapped as fair sunshine.
I'm a friend.
are no longer doing Black Death, so will you please consider reinvesting?
I'm not talking to you! You ruined Romeo and Juliet! No, I'm off to see Richard the Third.
Oh yeah, Richard can't find a horse and then he dies.
Oh, stop it! Stop it!
New bloke! You up for this or not?
Don't worry about me, I'm as strong as the next guy.
Bean, what are you doing? I told you to cut this out!
I know, but they were looking for good, strong men to haul the stage away. Well, how come they're never looking for good, strong women?
Because some jobs are just more suited for men. Now give me that. It's so heavy. Are you okay?
Actually, I was gonna tell you the news when you got home, but... you know how I've been having these wild mood swings? There's a reason for it.
Oh God! You've got the plague!
Nope. I'm pregnant.
You sure it's not the plague? It's great news!
Hey, you're gonna be a father.
Oh my God.
A family, just like we always wanted.
How's it going, guys?
Oh, okay.
I'm working on it.
And so am I. I better get back to it.
Well, no. You go home and rest.
I love you.
I love you too. I'm gonna be a father.
Hello, Nick. Ready to reconsider my offer?
No, Shylock.
Because you're prejudiced against the Jew?
Not me. All of Renaissance Europe. I can't risk it. I've already got you-know-who saying my writing's the work of Satan and I deserve to burn in hell.
Don't listen to critics, Stefanotta. Come on, Nick. Young men, let me help.
I'm not that desperate.
Really? You have no show. No patron. Oh, and your brother is at a private party for William Shakespeare.
What? I'll kill him!
It's invitation only! And guess who has an invitation?
Young Bottom, I see.
Hi. I want to talk to you. Not now. Nigel Bottom, playwright, poet, prestigious prodigy.
Ooh, that's a lot of alliteration. Occupational hazard. Oh, there you are. Now stay there.
So, Mickey Bottom's little brother, his secret weapon, all grown up. Pray tell, who is this delightful damsel, this maiden fair, this feast for the eyes?
Oh, I'm sorry. This is Portia.
Portia?
Yep.
Good name. That's right, this is happening. Just breathe, yeah.
Master Shakespeare!
Oh, she's bedazzled. Do you like that word? I just made it up. That's what I do, you don't think of that!
Oh, thank you. I think I just need to just sit down. Oh!
So, Nigel, what are you and that brother of yours working on now? A comedy? A tragedy?
What?
A tragic attempt at a comedy? See what I did. See what I did.
Actually, he doesn't want me to tell anybody about it, so...
Oh, God, he's so paranoid. Always has been. Even when I was a lowly actor in this sad little troupe, he was so insecure.
course, and you as his partner, he has even more reason today. I read your sonnet. Oh, it's good. It's quite good. I'd like to read more. Oh, is that your folio?
This? Oh, no. No, this is just a collection of writings about some musings.
Would you like me to give it a looky-loo, what am I saying? Of course you would. I'm Shakespeare.
Shakespeare!
All the world's a stage. Mm. Don't I know it, darling?
Excuse me! Come on, let him in! It's okay! He's my plus one!
Trust me, I have no desire to stay. I'm just looking for my brother. There you are. I... Oh!
Hello, Will.
Hello, Nick. It's been a long time.
Yeah, not long enough. Is that my brother's notebook? Nice try!
No. He was just offering to look at my ideas.
Or his ideas, as they'd soon be known.
Oh! Do you bite your thumb at me, sir?
Really? Quoting Romeo and Juliet? It's pathetic.
By my troth, the tartness of his face doth sour the ripened grape.
Well, by my troth, your grape is stupid.
Such a clever retort. And you can't try to hit. No. We should actually thank this man. He was the one who suggested I take up writing in the first place.
Because you're a shit actor.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Oh, no, I'm not.
You're a child!
Oh, where is she? Where is my daughter?
Push her!
You said you'd be in your room reading your Bible!
Oh, Bible.
Hear me now, sinner. You dare defy me and corrupt my daughter. So help me God! I will smite these bottoms and smite them hard!
Smite their bottoms!
Portia! Let go of me! I'm not a child!
Then why are you acting like one? I told you to stay away from that girl. Now look what's happened. We're on the most wanted list of a deranged Puritan, and Shakespeare almost got your notebook full of ideas, which, by the way, is the only reason he invited you here.
No!
Oh, you're so naive. You gotta watch your back with this guy. Believe me, I know every trick in his book.
This is all very confusing, you know. I know she's gone, and I've lost my inspiration, and the love of my life.
Nigel.
I need to get her back!
Nigel, you got a show to write!
Go! Stop! Ready to reconsider now?
You know what? Why the hell not? Let's do it!
Really?
Yeah.
Muscle on! I love it! So tell me, Nikki, what's our new show about?
Well, we're still looking for that great idea.
Too bad you can't get a peek into Shakespeare's notebook, huh? Oh, we're gonna take home and thank you, buddy!
How goes it with your musical?
Not so great, actually. We're having a hard time figuring out what a musical should be about.
Chess.
Chess?
No, that can't possibly work. Little shop of a whore.
Really? That doesn't sound right.
And now, why is the shop little? Small wars?
The truth is, I'm kind of desperate. I need an idea that is guaranteed to be a success. So I want you to look into the future and tell me, what will Shakespeare's greatest play be?
No, I assure you I want to cross that line. Wouldn't you rather just come up with an idea of your own?
Of course I would, and I've tried. I can't. I mean, maybe if I had more time and less pressure, but I just need one hit to get me out of this hole.
I must warn you, for this you will pay a great price.
I brought every penny I have.
That's not what I meant.
Are you sure this will work? Because I've got everything riding on this, and now I've got a baby on the way.
Which I predicted, remember? A new life with no teeth. Oh! Shakespeare's
yes.
What they will be talking about for generations to come.
Yes!
And this play will be called... omelette!
Oh, like with the eggs?
Yes. No, wait. No, that's right, omelette. Yeah. Something Danish.
Oh, a Danish, so there's some sort of breakfast thing.
Ham? Ham? Ham something?
Ham omelette?
That must be.
And you're sure it'll be made.
It will be known as perhaps the single greatest play ever written.
Yes.
Oh, so many images. So many.
Write it down, all of them.
Let me get my quill.
Oh, man. This is going to solve so many problems. My future is suddenly looking brighter.
No more Mr. Anonymous. No more world that is Nick Bottomless. My name will be synonymous with being on the top. I can see it now. I look and see y'all. It's a hit town. It's gonna be great, gonna be great. Everywhere I go, they will love me.
Loving it, can't get enough of it. Everyone, even including the queen.
She originally invited me to her castle where she liked me, and privately she told me that you're not any good, not any good, not any good, not any good. And she told me that all of your plates make her vomit, and nothing's as good as my musical omelette.
Wait a minute. You have an omelette?
Yes.
I never thought that I would meet my equal, but I concede I have been bested by the best. Maybe we could partner on a sequel.
Oh my, how the tide has turned. Learn from you, what have we learned? To see you in fear, but now we swap, so kiss this bottom, I'm on the top!
Autograph seeker, I want a piece of this.
Give me a cross.
but I bear him like Jesus. I swear it's a burden, and I suffer through it.
He suffers so hard,
the game, the traffic's the play.
I don't believe he's going to do it, so he does.
I know, I gotta go, get back to my pen and ink. Oh, don't make me do it, don't make me go through it. Can somebody get me a drink? Cause it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's really hard. It's sexy, but it's hard. Me famous, but being famous is just so much more fun. You see, what people just don't understand is that writing's demanding, it's mentally challenging, and it's a bore, it's such a chore. Just sit in a room by yourself and I'm trying to hate it. And you're trying to find an opening line of a brilliant idea, and you're greasing the floor and hoping for, just a bit of divine intervention. That one little nugget, that one little spark, and eureka, you find it, you're ready to start. So now you can write, right? Wrong, you're not even close, you remember the damn your place gonna be in my epitaph. So you write down a word, but it's not the right word. So you try a new word, but you hate a new word. And you need a good word, but you can't find the word. Oh, what is it? Where is it? Where is it? What 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 is it, my little friend? What is it? Share your secrets with me. What is it?
Please stop blowing in my face. Also, just a quick FYI, everyone thinks you're a fraud.
Shut up, mother.
Sir?
You asked for information about what the other bottom is writing. Our spy is here with the news.
Did he see me losing it?
He's half blind, sir.
Oh, good, then he only saw half of it. See what it is.
Oh, yeah!
Speak, man, what news?
I saw Nick Bonham one day. He played a soothsayer to foresee what Shakespeare's greatest play would be.
That sneaky little thief. Why doesn't he come up with his own ideas?
It's hard.
No, it is. Isn't it? It's really the worst.
It's hard.
Makes me wonder why I didn't think of that first
time. Hard to alleviate the pressure to create.
It's hard.
Something as good as the last thing I did, that was already great.
It's hard,
it's hard, it's hard, it's hard. Well, that works to my expertise.
All that I need is a clever disguise. I can pay for a devious lie. I can do all the tedious stuff, the work that's terribly and apparently hard. All right, Nick Bottom, I think Shakespeare needs to find out what Shakespeare's next big hit will be. Everyone knows my name, I can't help it, it's still frickin' hard.
Hey, Paul, just to make sure I got this all straight, we've got a prince eating a Danish who is visited by the ghost of his dead father.
Not a ghost, the phantom. He was the former king who was murdered by the prince's uncle. And the uncle's name is... Scar.
The prince is in love, but she goes mad, you say?
Yes, but how do you solve a problem like Ophelia?
Right, how do you?
The prince says, get thee to a nunnery. And then the nuns hide her and all of the same children. Nazis!
And these Nazis, are they good guys or bad?
Not sure. It's important to get that one right.
Now remember, stay over here and don't say anything.
Oh, the theater! I love it, I love it, I love it!
Shy Lock, you're just in time. Have a seat, we're just about to start.
I love it.
You haven't seen it yet.
I know, but I just love being here. I'm for clamped, I tell you.
Isn't it illegal to have a Jewish patron?
Well, he's not a patron. He is producing money for the production to get it produced. So we call him a... Well, I haven't got a title for it yet. Okay. Now, let's take it from the top of the song. Watch and weep, Shakespeare. Watch and weep.
What's that cooking on the griddle? It's eggs, it's eggs. Throw something in the middle. Something for eating. It's eggs, it's eggs.
This puppy bowl, this scrambled nature of my soul. I'm cracking up as I begin to see the bits of me within this. Metaphor. The griddle is his mind. What's he thinking? Eggs. The symbol of life. But his thoughts are all scrambled. He's cracking up like an egg.
Yeah, I'm not getting any of that.
Yeah, neither am I. I wrote it. I mean, what's a fiddler? And why is he on the roof?
The roof is where the chimney is. Quit overthinking.
I'm just thinking about the audience. You know, the people who've come in from Jersey.
Jersey?
In the Channel Islands, next to Guernsey.
Oh.
It's the south of the earth, people. They work hard all week. They don't want metaphors. They want good old-fashioned fellas entertainment. Cats!
What?
Monumental. Bigger than Shakespeare.
That's right, Toby, was it?
From York, yes.
Ah, we are working on something pretty special. It's a play full of songs about an omelette.
I!
That's the great idea.
What?
I said, that's a great idea.
Who?
Here's my head sketch and resume.
You've been in every one of my plays.
I'm a massive fan. It's so unfair that Shakespeare gets all the praise and attention and the money. And your plays are in a class all their own.
I like the New York actor. You're hired. Shakespeare cast member Toby Belch. He's in the song, huh? Hey, where do you think you're going? We've got a whole second act to sort out.
I just got another idea that I want to accept.
Let's not go through this again. This is the idea. Omelette.
Yeah, and I told you something about that. It just doesn't feel right. And besides, I have another idea that I want to write on my own. So I'm going to go.
I get it. You want to go see her, don't you? Well, that is not going to happen. Don't stay. Do not, Nigel! That girl!
Yoko!
What? I have no idea!
Portia!
Oh, Nigel! Oh, you made it! I'm gonna climb out of a window, but I don't think anyone saw me.
Are you certain that you want to do this?
Yes.
Because you don't have to if you don't want to.
No, I want to. I'm just nervous, that's all.
So am I. Is he okay, or?
Yeah.
Okay, here you go.
Yes.
Okay. Ode behind the bottom. Okay. I start something I've never seen in here. This one this time. And there's no pain.
Slow down.
Hey.
Oh, I know,
I'm sorry. I guess I'm a little more nervous than I thought I was going to be. Can I try that again? Okay, sorry. Ready? Like stars and sun together, never seen, yet heaven made us one. Our flames to shine through night and day, no dusk nor dawn between, yet none could dim our light nor love divine. Astronomers, behold these starry eyes. Forbidden love to seek our hearts be loud.
Keep going.
If laws of man are seeking love to die, so love is love loud.
Yes.
If you talk about it, then keep my turn. Oh, I finished too quickly.
Oh, wander off to seek your lustful desire.
Please read your poem.
Oh, flowers, listen, is that by me? No,
silence!
You will tap my daughter no more. She'll be locked in the church tower, and there she will stay until her exile for a brother in Scotland.
No!
Portia!
Frightened to me, Elijah!
I will! I promise!
I love you!
I love you!
I am warning you more than you are me! Or you will pay dearly!
Ow.
Portia!
And my destiny is to be fortune's fool. If my pen be my one and my only companion, let it speak for my soul.
Guys, everybody listen up, please. Listen up. This is going to be a little bit rough. Oh, gosh. I've been working on it all night, but I need Francis. Where's Francis? Francis, okay. I want you to read Nick's part, okay? And I need you to
right here.
Oh, sorry. I heard you. Sorry, right here. And everybody else, if you can also take your places, please.
Is Nick okay with all of
this? No, he will be. I promise. Francis, please.
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against the sea of troubles.
Proper literature, that is. No, wait, I want to keep going, Robin. I would like to take it from your entrance, please. Thank
you. Oh, that this too solid flesh would melt, thaw, and resolve itself into a dew.
Frailty, nameless woman, get thee to a nunnery.
Hold thy tongue!
Lady, don't protest too much, methinks!
What the hell?
Nick, your little brother has written something really great.
Yeah, this is better than Shakespeare.
Is it? You started without me?
Nick, I got inspired. Listen, okay, you gave me all these insane ideas, right? And I took the ones that made some sense, and I wrote something that just it rings true in here.
Nigel,
no, just hear me out. Listen. Okay, it's about a prince who is full of anguish for a great loss, and he realizes that his own life has no meaning. He is so depressed that he wants to kill himself, but he can't even make up his mind about that. And then his true love is forced into a religious exile where she probably dies of a broken heart, and then he descends into madness, and then he dies, and everyone dies, and the whole stage is covered in bodies, and blood, and death, and the rest is silence. And we're all left to die, to sleep, perchance to dream.
That's the great idea.
That is what you stayed up all night working on? This has nothing to do with eggs.
That's what's missing. Why don't I collect these and hold them for safekeeping?
No, wait, Nick, please just read it. Just keep reading. I really think that I am onto something here.
I am reading, and where's the omelette?
Nick, come on. There isn't an omelette.
What do you mean there's no omelette? There has to be an omelette. It's called omelette.
Ah! Are you hearing yourself?
What?
Nick, are you hearing yourself?
Yes.
I can't believe we're having a conversation about a story that has to be all about eggs.
So?
Eggs?
Yes.
What is it with you and these eggs?
You just have to trust me. I know what I'm doing.
No, I think you're out of your mind. You think that pursuing that is a good thing.
Well, I do.
Okay, well, I don't.
Read him this part. It's beautiful.
It doesn't matter. Not gonna listen.
I should really take these before this turns ugly.
Read and watch out.
What the hell are they talking about?
You told me to write something? Well, here it is.
Short as the day follows the night, short as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true, above all else and whatever you do, to thy own self.
Good wine and good advice. Exactly! But there's no Danish, there's no ham, there's no eggs! You're completely ignoring the theme!
I'm ignoring the breakfast theme because it's ridiculous!
Oh! Are you hearing yourself?
Yeah.
I said, are you hearing yourself?
Yeah!
I can't believe you're trying to change direction because you've decided that my ideas are wrong.
Please.
I'm wrong, but this truth or something is right.
No, that's not just a lie, it's what I believe!
And you are a fool and really naive if you think it's as simple as that!
I do!
People, I don't!
May I?
Oh, sure. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
When sorrows come, they come not single spies, but in battalions.
Is it that bad?
No. No, no.
It's just...
To be or not to be... What a piece of work is man. It's a lot of cliches.
Wait up. You mean all of that has been done before? Or?
Oh. Yeah. As your friend, I will read this to see if there's anything here that can be salvaged, but I don't want to see this with your name on it. But this musical, Omelette, all of London is buzzing about it.
Really? Oh, but how come it's so...
Bold! Daring! Yeah. A lesser writer would shy away. But you. Write your omelets.
Write your omelet. Write your omelet. Come on, you can do this. You can do this. No, I can't do this, Nick. It's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. And I can't wait to see what the two of you come up with. I
I'm sure you'll give them a show they'll never forget.
Frailty, thy name is Egg. How like thee I am. For I am what I am, and what I am doth be an illusion.
You better, my lord.
Where is McCavity?
At the Jellicoe Ball, he would not stop.
Go and fetch him.
Alas, my lord, my vexes thee.
I dreamed a dream.
Horatio.
An impossible dream. There were wheels upon yon dream, and raindrops upon Rosencrantz. We've got trouble.
Trouble,
I said! The king lies dead, and the serpent that did sting his life now wears his crown. Where is McCavity?
McCavity's not there.
Sound!
What's we going to fall? I could have danced all night.
My nonsense was worrisome for the king and I.
My lord, if married, would not be so.
Where be the king?
Gentle fellows, what news?
The Nazis have arrived!
The Nazis. The Nazis are such good men, blood and blood. With their succor, we shall make war against the Puerto Ricans.
Tonight!
Oh, luck be thy lady tonight.
Head. God, I hope I get it!
Fair guests! Feel coming! Bienvenue! Welcome! The wedding breakfast is served.
My father, newly dead, and the funeral boiled eggs now coldly furnish forth the marriage table. Methinks another chef might have whisked our disparate eggs together as one.
Pray, nephew, what dost thou mean?
Well, I'll tell you. The fruit of life can't always taste like sweet persimmons. Sometimes it's hard to swallow, I'm afraid. But when life has handed you some lemons, then hand it back a mug of lemonade. My father said this to me, that he did, and then he blew me away. He said, Egbert, life is merely what you think of it. So heed this sound advice. You make wine from sour grapes. You got a hot pancake, all the crates when life gives you eggs.
Oh,
so sorry. Just can answer him. I have a question.
Why, fair Uncle Star? Why dost thou speakest when thou shouldn't speakest?
Because I want to know, how canst thou make an omelette when one of the eggs be rotten?
Is this in the script?
Ah, therein lies the rub. The rotten one is you!
Toby?
Or not Toby? That is the question.
You little snake!
And you said I was a shit hack.
You will not make an ass of me.
No need. You've got a fine job on your own.
What's going on?
Allow me, since Master Bottom's plots are hard to follow. This man is a soothsayer! He was hired by this man to look into the future and steal my greatest idea!
I can't believe I would ever come up with this shit.
Nick, is this true?
Guys, I can explain.
You lied to me!
I don't understand.
No, I don't. I don't.
Nice try, Nick. Just one last thing. Shakespeare's Richard II, Globe Theatre, previews begin Saturday.
Okay, bye.
That's right, this just happened.
I have failed in every way. I could have told you this would happen,
but you wouldn't have listened.
No, you did tell me. You said there'd be a great price. And now I have to pay it.
Order! Order! Silence in the court!
I shall arouse me to order this vile and offensive production.
It was my duty as a magistrate, but more importantly, my duty to God, to have them arrested for blasphemy, treason, employment of a Jew,
witchcraft, and the provocative parading of eggs.
Offences, the law demands
beheading.
Defendants to have a lawyer present.
No, Your Grace.
Cool, Richard! I am their lawyer. And I say beheading this man would be redundant. Clearly, the fool has lost his head already. Beat me more. Specific? Oh, I shall. Did you take the money from the money box?
Yes.
Did you deceive your brother?
Yes.
Did you ignore the advice of your wife, who, by all accounts, is a wonderful and supportive woman? Write that down. Well?
Yes. I did all of those things.
Which is why I enter a plea of temporary insanity. Before sentencing is pronounced, I think we'd all like to know what on earth were you thinking?
The learned counselor is right. I lost my mind. No, worse, I lost myself. And it wouldn't have happened if I had just listened. Someone much wiser than me tried to tell me.
Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true. Above all else, in whatever you do, to thine own self be true.
Why did I wander so far from the man that the two of you knew I could hate? I lost sight of all that mattered somehow. I could not see it then, but I see it now. I just didn't think I had it in me. So I made it harder than it had to be.
have listened to you through my own self, me too, to my own self, me too.
That's very touching, for the law demands beheading, and nothing can change that.
Or can it?
The defense calls Master William Shakespeare.
If it please the court.
You, the court is very pleased.
Continue. Oh. Words without thoughts never to heaven go.
Oh, I love how I put words in the wrong order.
And the quality of mercy is not strained. It droppeth as the gentle rain from heaven. But if a merciful ending is not written here today, then on my stage shall I replay these events with these characters and thee at thy bench. There shall I see fair justice done.
Are you saying you might write a play about this? With me as a character? Well, I wouldn't want to look the fool.
And you shan't, Lord Falstaff. Not if you spare their lives and see these mischief makers vanishing. Send them off this royal throne of kings, this sceptred isle, this blessed plot, this earth, this realm, this England!
This is so much more elegant than beheading, I agree. Defendants, I sentence you to be banished, transported on the first ship for the new world, and take your so-called musicals with you. Look! Homosexuals! Come back! Charge them!
Oh, please. I'm a woman.
You're welcome.
For what? All those lines are from my pages. You're just getting us out of the way so you can steal my work.
Getting beheaded would have been out of the way as well. No. The world is better with you in it. Just not...
my world.
Besides, this remarkable woman and impressive actor persuaded me that I can make a stand for free speech today.
Yeah, I see you had about 20 free speeches there, so...
Hey, let it go. Hey, all's well that ends well.
Ah. Good lie!
Stop giving your best stuff!
Good night, sweet prince. Lights of angels. Do something. Exit Shakespeare.
Portia!
Portia!
I thought I would never see you again.
Portia, what are you doing here? I sent you away!
But I'm going, but not before I say goodbye.
Very well, I will allow it.
It pains the heart to say adieu to some you love, but alas, the time has come. Goodbye, Father. Good man's children shall prosper the wilderness. Psalms 112. You have your poets, and I will have mine.
What? No! Oh, God damn it!
I do it. You deal with Shakespeare?
We wanted a new country home. And now we're getting a home in a new country.
Well, I didn't see that coming. Out here in the new world, a guy like me can be anything he wants.
And then we'll be open to something really original.
And brother, I know just the story we should tell.
Ladies and gentlemen, Skybar Productions, in association with Film Enterprises,